Hello everybody, welcome back to another video. I'm hoping you guys are all having a fantastic day. So today's upload is going to be about why is the pattern so conducive to severe weather, and just this whole pattern set up, you know, what's coming up, and obviously I gave it away. Severe weather is coming up, lots and lots of it. Heavy rain, large hail, tornado threat, maybe not as much, maybe more limited, but hail and wind and rain are gonna be the main things. Yesterday we were about to get hit by a fairly strong, powerful storm, a thunderstorm, and it was 1 o'clock in the morning. I sat up because it was so darn close to us, and thankfully did not get hit because the hail was ping pong ball sized hail. It was massive, and I might upload a little video. And it was an insane lightning show, guys. I mean, the lightning was absolutely ridiculous. It was flashing all over the place. It was like bright outside at 1 o'clock in the morning. It was beyond me, but we thankfully got missed by that. But you know, it's definitely not over. The threat's still gonna continue. And if you like to support this channel, if you like these videos, consider subscribing to this channel. All you gotta do is scroll a little bit down and you see a button like this, and it's gonna be red if you're not subscribed. Click on a subscribe button, and if you are so kind and you are subscribed, you could click on a bell notification icon. That basically notifies you every time a video is made, and it's just a benefit if you want to. Also, you could like this video and become a Patreon. You could just click on the link in the description box below, become a Patreon, $2, $4 if you want. It's completely optional, but I just thought I'd let you know. Completely optional though, again. So let's just jump right into this. Right now we're looking at a system fairly strong. I mean, it's a fairly well organized system for May, for a summer spring system. Usually we see winter systems being, you know, the strong ones, the more organized ones, the ones that are, you know, I don't know how to describe this, the ones that actually have a broad area of rain or snow across this, across these, you know, portions. But it's been a unique year this year, I'm telling you guys. This system, you can see, it's looks like a classical system that would occur in winter. And it has like a little, right there, has an inflow. It's basically the cold front that's dragging behind. And right up here, that's a horrible arrow. Come on, let's do a better job with this. No, I want to keep recording. So, I think we're keep recording. Okay, so basically, the system, you can see, has a cold front right here, and it's going to drag quite a bit of severe weather up here. I mean, there's going to be a lot of severe weather in this area. So let's just go play this out through this. So you can see, I'm sorry, I'm still getting used to this. This recording software is not the best. I'll have to get a newer one. But you can see it brings up a hole, and this is going to occur today in the afternoon, maybe while you're watching this video, if you're watching around 4 or 5 o'clock. So you can see this thing will be massive. I mean, right now at the radar, if you look at the radar, it's not looking too impressive. I don't know if the Storm Prediction Center radar will show up. Okay, but see, you can see the only severe thunderstorm watch is right here. And that is, you can see this is what the radar looks like. Let's quickly go. There's some thunderstorms by Rapid City here in Wyoming and northern Colorado, but nothing too impressive yet, but it'll just absolutely explode. The ingredients are there. I mean, look at that moisture across the west. I mean, absolutely giant Pacific storms coming off the west, and these are just bringing loads of moisture in, and it's warm, very warm, especially across the south and east, so these storms have just so much fuel, and look at that. That is prime severe weather, large hail, damaging wind, tornadoes, maybe not as much, but still a threat, and heavy rain. That's probably the number one threat. In terms of rain, it doesn't really make a thunderstorm severe just off its rain intensity. You can't have a severe thunderstorm warning just because of heavy rain, but you know, usually with that heavy rain, the strong wind and hail goes sometimes hand in hand. But very heavy rain, and this will, you know, occur over the same areas. And then we see another, kind of like a second piece of the system develop across Sunday, and this will receive a new whole batch of moisture from the south and produce more thunderstorms across Wisconsin, Minnesota. You can see just a little bit further to the south, but still similar areas, so flooding could occur. And notice how, interestingly enough, the contrasts are insane. Look at this. Comes some snow, possibly, in South Dakota and North Dakota. And you may seem not surprised by that. It's May, snow still possible. Yeah, but it just goes to show you how big of the contrast is, because if we look at the 2 meter temperature shaded, you'll be fairly impressed. So these are the nighttime lows. Let's go a couple hours back and let's show you the daytime highs. Look at this. There are 80s, 70s all across this area, and there's snow right up here. So these systems, like I was saying, have very characteristic designs. So there's a cold front that's dragging across here. There's a warm front up here. That's why there's such a fine line between the cold, that's a horrible seat, cold and the warm. And there's also the storm is bringing up a bunch of warm air while it's also bringing down plenty of cool air behind it, and that is producing quite a bit of cool conditions right here. And I mean, out ahead of it, it's just so warm. There's a huge ridge, and this is just producing so much more warmth than a typical, you know, May storm would. And typical May storm wouldn't produce such contrast. This was more likely of April or late March. But this weather has been absolutely crazy. Look at that thin line between the 70s, the 80s, and the 40s, and the 30s, and the 50s. So, you know, it really, like today here in Chicago, we are looking at a 40 degree day, 49 yesterday. We were in the 80s. Tomorrow we were going to be in the 80s. And this is exactly what the thunderstorms are looking for. They're looking for these star conditions, these changing drastic conditions, changes in height of wind and pressure and everything that the storm does have. And that just causes these thunderstorms to explode in size, in magnitude, and in severity. So let's just go back to the rain/frozen, and let's quickly check out what's going on. So we're at 6, 12 hours, 18 hours. Again, we went over this. Another batch occurs on Sunday. You may think that's over, but no, we see another system developing here, producing another batch of severe weather. You can see this is more centered across the Oklahoma area, southern Kansas and Missouri, maybe northwest Arkansas. And look, this is Tuesday, late Monday. Only a couple of days after this system just finished passing through the Midwest. And look at that, yet again, severe weather across the Midwest Wednesday, and more heavy rain for the North Dakota area, the Upper Plains. And this system, again, ridiculously strong, 987 for a summer system that usually is not too common. And then we see more of a spring pattern where we don't really see a low associated with this. We just see these scattered little storms. We see these little waves, these short waves, these upper waves that occur, these little disturbances in atmosphere. Not necessarily, you don't see a strong low here, but we could still see strong severe weather. And that's what usually happens in the summer. We usually don't see a pattern, and you could see it continues, but we usually don't see a pattern where we see such a strong system and it's so late in the season. And when you do have such a strong system, severe weather is just gonna be exploding across the region. Think about this logically, guys. So in the usually severe weather is the strongest in the spring and late fall, possibly also, but the main season is late spring and late fall. And late spring is stronger though, but late spring and late fall, the reason for that is these storms occur all through winter. We don't really see just sporadic snow showers come out of nowhere. We do sometimes, but it's usually not strong. But if we have a stronger snowstorm, we usually see a system like this, you know, coming out of the west or any direction, frankly. It just needs to have a cold front, strong warm front, strong drag from the Gulf of Mexico, and strong pull behind it, bringing in a cold air. And that usually brings so much severe weather. And that's why usually April is a month of severe weather, because we see those storms still happening since it's cold enough in the atmosphere for those storms. And it's just the right conditions. It's still winter time. And we see these giant severe weather outbreaks in April. And when we have one of these storms in May, it just goes absolutely ridiculous. We see this low is literally a breeding ground for these thunderstorms. And look, some of these will be just ridiculously strong. Mark my words, there's already, if we go to the Storm Prediction Center, let's go back to the actual outlooks. We already have enhanced for Friday, enhanced for Saturday, enhanced for, and just severe for Monday, but it's the same color as enhanced, which means it's already the same percentage as enhanced, and I would not be surprised to see one of these areas pop up to moderate, in the upcoming days. But, definitely, a severe weather pattern going on that's robust and active. So the video will end, or the video will pause for now, because again, it's going over 10 minutes, so I apologize about that. And we are back, guys. So you can see, again, this is today's outlook. Slight and two enhanced areas. So it's all over the country, basically. You can see one's in the mid-Atlantic, the Washington, D.C. areas. One is down here in La Texas. There is an area in the upper plains. Again, that's where the strongest storms will occur because the low is literally centered right underneath it. And enhanced and slight, but again, anywhere that's marginal could still see a severe thunderstorm, and anywhere that's in the green could see a thunderstorm. Maybe not a severe thunderstorm, but definitely a thunderstorm. So I mean, it's very active. Tomorrow for Saturday, we are looking at a little bit further again to the east, but there's still an enhanced area, there's a slight area, and there's a marginal area. And look at the amount of population that is in the slight. I mean, ridiculous, more than in the marginal area, 31 million people. Houston, San Antonio, Fort Worth, Oklahoma City, Kansas City, Missouri, those are just only some of the cities. Des Moines, Iowa is another one. Topeka, Kansas is another one. There's just so many. Dallas is another one. So definitely plenty of cities and population affected under this. Sunday, maybe a little bit less if we go here. This is Sunday, a little bit further to these, but still we have a slight risk, which is plenty enough to produce severe weather. Let's go to Monday. There's severe already, so enhanced area. Another enhanced area. You can see for this, hopefully this will load. We see Texas, Oklahoma, Northwest Arkansas, and then you can see it moves on a little bit further east as we go on right there. So very, very interesting, very intriguing pattern. And I want to show you some of these temperature anomalies. I mean, they're just obnoxiously strong. So we see much above average across the southeast and the south, while in some areas, look at this, it is way below average. Some areas even seeing snow from this system, while other areas baking in the 90s and even the 80s. I mean, just look at that. That is just ridiculous. Look at that. Holy smokes, guys, that is cold, cold, cold. And look at this, that is warm, warm, warm. These two contrasting air masses, that's just all you need. Not all you need, but that's two of the big things that you need in order for severe weather to go into exponential amounts like it's going right now. So thank you guys so much for watching. Consider liking the video, consider becoming a Patreon, and I'll see you guys all in the next episode. See ya, bye.